Started all of that old Obama music with your album this afternoon. I hope you take responsibility for all of that. And we have to acknowledge our fashion designer in the back of the room who gave us these shirts. Tomo Renan over there.
Yeah. Well, that's a good graphic. Thank you.
We've been sharing some songs with you and some stories about our place down the road. But you know, Kailua has a very special place in my heart. Danny was a janitor in Kailua Elementary School when we were growing up. You know, people worked hard to try and put food on the table for their children. And so I started school before I was in kindergarten because I came to school with my older sister and they just let me stay in the classroom.
Well, it's not a thing anymore.
Kailua has so much alumni, and my auntie Ella lived right where Chinky is now, behind Kalapoy. So we would come visit her and spend the day at Kailua Beach. Over the years, you know, Kailua certainly has changed for those of you who are from this area and watched it grow over the years. How important it is to continue to tell our stories, for the face of the land may change, but in the music, in the life stories, lies the connection to the land. And if we want people to feel the way about our home that we did, maybe some time ago, we have to continue to share those stories with each other. And over on this side, we have been blessed with some people who do just that. Many of you knew Auntie Irmgard Farden Aluli, and all of her ohana, all the girls, Ohana and Gang, who will grace Kailua with their music for many years. And right down the road on that way is a husband and wife team that are practitioners of hula. And for those of us who are interested in the stories and connections that take us back in time, certainly we are grateful to Motuana and T.A. Bisilwa for doing just that and reminding us of the old days. It is said Kihei wrote this song for his grandchildren so that they would know when they went out to the walk with Grandpa in the morning